to present the Favorite Soul R&B Album Award. Here are Taylor Dane and George Benson.
And the winner is... George Michael!
I'm very pleased to be old enough and secure enough not to care if people take offense if I tell the truth.
All right, we're gonna look at today's lack of both black music and the black artists who perform it. Mtume predicted this over 20 years ago. We're gonna go back and hear what he said. This is crazy, y'all. Check it out. Let's go back to 1994. Mtume.
Dealing with the music. Yeah. There's a few things we have to be clear about. There's no accident that most of the people who sit up heading A&R departments, most, not all, I call A&R anal and rectum. Yeah, let me tell you why. I'm very serious about this. Because what you have witnessed is the total and absolute destruction of adult black contemporary music. They would rather have you sign or watch 10-year-old kids grind doing a ballad than they would let you see the groups that paved the way for what y'all are doing. Now let me give you a quick history lesson. This didn't just happen. Quick history lesson. There was a group called the Supremes. Take the lead singer, the group died. There's another group called Rufus. Take the lead singer, the group died. There's another group called the Commodores. Y'all following me? Take the lead singer, the group died. There was another group called Hal Melvin and the Blue Notes. Take the lead singer, the group dies. There was another group called LTD. Take the lead singer, the group dies. It was a group called the Jackson Motherfucking Five. Take the lead singer, the group dies. There was another group called Freedom Again. Take the lead singer, and the group dies. Now, conversely, I don't want anybody to think I'm not being equal here. Ain't nobody in the world bigger than Phil Collins. Is he still with Genesis? Yes. Ain't nobody bigger than Mick Jagger. And Keith Richards, they do solo albums. Because I believe lead singers should have the option to do solo material. Have they left the Rolling Stones? No. So what you have to understand, that there has been a systematic development that we slept. And now, you don't have any black representation of adult music. Everybody's had the biggest year you ever had last year. Rod Stewart is out there. All those groups out there. You know when it became really clear? About 5 or 6 years ago when they gave Black Album of the Year to George Michael, who had an excellent album, but that was not the Black Album of the Year, especially with Guy, Keith Sweat, or Albie Shore's first album was out. But we didn't say nothing. No, don't clap, because we fucked up. We didn't say nothing. We let go by. Now they systematically eliminated it. And what I'm trying to tell you, brothers and sisters, is that all your professors have to take it out of your class. Because the bottom line is, you are now suffering. Because what they've also done in doing that, they've reduced you to hit records. See, when I was coming up, you know, the goal was to have a hit career. Y'all don't even know what that is. You are measured by records, not years. You know, you wait for the next Earth, Wind, and Fire, the next Parliament, the next Isley Brothers. That was 10, 15-year runs. How many people have those runs now? I'm talking about I'm crazy with the R&B tip. It's crazy how far out this is going. I'm trying to tell you, I don't mean to be blowing no horn of desperation. It's a serious situation that you're in, because you got to understand this is part of a much larger plan. And the plan is to have black music without black people.
So there you have it. Black music without black people. It's just like it was with rock and roll. They want to hear it. It's just in the U.S., they don't want to see U.S. doing it. Not because hip-hop and rap took over, because the same thing that happened to jazz and rock and roll and R&B is happening with rap now. And just because I mention this, don't accuse me of doing hostile music. I'm just tired of the emphasis being placed on white artists doing our style music, while our contributions somehow wind up in music history's trash bin. How much longer we gonna sit and watch white artists become legends while black ones become has-beens?
I don't know.
For favorite album, Soul R&B.
The winner is, You Kids on the Block.
The winner for group album of the year is, Backstreet Boys.
And the winner is,
for the best rap album.
Check out the nominees.
Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch.
The favorite new rap artist.
And the winner is Vanilla Ice.
And the Grammy goes to
Macklemore and Ryan Lewis.
Or favorite rap hip hop album.
Iggy Azalea.
Y'all follow me?
Something that we gotta always fight against, man. Whether we come off as bitter, whether we come off as old, somebody gotta fight for something. And then when we don't fight for it, Justin Timberlake is gonna get props for being the greatest African American entertainer of our time.
Oh, man.